Hi, my name's Yana with the Down Tube, and I wanted to talk about carving turns in this video and how to carve turns. And that's something I'm defining myself. Carving turns means, you know, going into a turn, not pedaling in the turn, and leaving the turn with as much momentum as possible. So it took me a very long time to learn to hold my momentum that I go into a turn with out of a turn. Honestly, I learned to do it when I was about 40 years old. And, you know, better late than never. And that's something I've really been instilling in my kids, trying to share exactly how to do it, because it's so much fun. You don't have to go fast on a bike. You can just, you know, do these turns. I mean, I go down this hill on a daily basis, and I just carve left and right turns constantly, and it's just really fun. So, and in addition, my kids do triathlons, and it's really funny. In this, there's this one hill, everybody goes down, and then they go up, and then there's a turn, and they go up a hill. And all the kids, they essentially on the turn, they like stop, and then they climb this hill. And, you know, I ride with my kids, and I, you know, fly down the hill, and I carve, and I just fly right up. It's really easy. When you hold your momentum, you can do more things, right? There are many more options out there, instead of losing your momentum and trying to regain it. So right here, I want to talk about how do you hold it? How do you hold the momentum? Okay, so let's assume I'm going to do a left-hand turn. Okay, so I'm not going to be on the bike for this, but yeah, I do have a bike here. If I'm going to be turning left, I'm going to put my right foot down. The right pedal is down. My foot is on the pedal. And I put as much weight on it as possible. Okay. So my weight is now shifted as much as possible to the right side. And the goal is to not turn the handlebar, because the minute you turn your handlebar, you're essentially, you're only gonna gain the cosine of the angle of the turn, so you're losing momentum instead of the turn. Okay? So as long as you keep your handlebar straight, the wheel straight, and then you start leaning your body to the left side. So I'm making a left turn, my weight goes to the right, and the weight goes to the right to make sure my bike does not drop. Okay? And I start leaning the bike as much as possible, keeping the handlebar straight. And, you know, it's not instantaneous, but eventually if you keep working on this, you know, you're gonna have to move your body around a little bit in the saddle, you know, depending on the road conditions and, you know, just how everything feels. But eventually you're gonna find that you're gonna be able to hold tons of momentum, and you can do things that you otherwise couldn't. Right? If you hold momentum, you can just play around a little bit better. So this is one of the coolest things I've been sharing with my kids, and they really appreciate it. They're not that good at it yet, but they know the rules, and they're always trying. When they go into our driveway, they always try to, you know, carve it really tight. And it's neat, and I'm just so excited and thankful to be able to share that. And I hope everybody out there can, you know, learn a little something from this, because, you know, it took me a very long time. 40 years is a little bit longer than I wish it took. Yeah, so and mind you, the exact procedure that I mentioned to make a left turn is the exact opposite to make a right turn. If I'm making a right turn, I would bring the left pedal all the way down, putting my weight all the way on the left side and leaning the bike to the right. Keep the handlebars as straight as possible. The minute the handlebars start turning, you're losing, okay? So what you're gaining is a cosine of the angle, you know, and you're losing the sine of the angle. That's the moment. You're losing at the middle. Thank you very much for watching.